Thank you. as so many of our gatherings during this year of COVID, is a little different today. Because obviously I'm here at St. Timothy's Church and you are there in school. But our gathering is just as important to God and to us as a community of believers, because we believe that wherever we are, Jesus is present. So Jesus is certainly present with you at school, as you gather as a community of faith to watch our gathering here at St. Timothy's virtually. Our celebration today is a little different from what we're used to. Most of the time we're used to celebrating the Eucharist, celebrating Mass. Well, we're celebrating the Eucharistic Jesus, but in a different way today. We're celebrating Jesus as he is present to us in his great sacrament. So many times in school, you have gone to the chapel. Those of you who are new this year wouldn't remember this so much, but you who have been students, who are veteran students at HLA, remember this. You have gone to the chapel to adore Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. And that is essentially what we're going to be doing today. When I come out, I'm going to place Jesus in this vessel that we refer to as a monstrance. Monstrance comes from a Latin word which means to show. And I put Jesus in this vessel, put the host right here so you can see it, and so that we can look at Jesus as we are adoring him. And I'm going to place him on our altar here at St. Timothy's. And then I'm going to honor Jesus in the Eucharist, in the Blessed Sacrament, with incense. We burn incense as Catholic Christians to show our honor and respect for whatever it is we are incensing, in this case, the Eucharist itself, and to show our prayers rising up to God. You're going to notice that I'm also going to be wearing a different kind of vestment. It's almost like a cape. It's called a cope, which comes from, again, the Latin word meaning cape. And we wear that vestment for special liturgies outside of Mass. That's why I'm not wearing a Mass vestment. I'm wearing this cope. And you're also going to notice that at the time when I give the benediction, when I bless you with the Eucharist in this monstrance, I'm going to make the sign of the cross over you with the monstrance. And at that point, you will make the sign of the cross yourself as I bless you. But you're going to notice that on top of the cope, I'm going to be wearing another vestment. It's a long scarf-like vestment called a veil, a humeral veil. And when I take the monstrance with that veil, I'm going to cover my hands with it. Many people think that's to show respect for the Eucharist. In one sense, it is. But more than that, we use that veil to cover the priest's hands to show that it is not me, I'm not the one who's blessing you, but Jesus himself is blessing you. And so I cover my hands to show you that. What we do today is a little bit different, but it's very much a part of our heritage of faith. And despite the limitations that restrict us today, it's a wonderful way for us to gather and to celebrate Jesus present to us in the Eucharist, no matter where we are, especially as we begin our Lenten journey. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Let us pray that Christ, the bread of life, will satisfy our human hungers. Father in heaven, you have made us for yourself. Our hearts are restless until they rest in you. Fulfill this longing through Jesus, the bread of life, so that we may witness to him who alone satisfies the hungers of the human family. By the power of your Spirit, lead us to the heavenly table, where we may feast on the vision of your glory forever and ever. Please remain standing for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Take care not to perform good deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no reward from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you do good to others, do not let your left hand know what your right is doing, so that your good deeds may be secret, and your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, who love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on street corners, so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go to your inner room, close the door, and pray to your Father in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face so that you may not appear to be fasting, except to your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. As we listen to these words of Jesus in St. Matthew's Gospel, several times in it, he uses the word hypocrite or hypocrites. A hypocrite is a person who says one thing, but does another. It's a person who essentially is not honest with him or herself or with others. So Jesus reminds us that we should not be hypocrites. We should be truthful and honest people who are rooted not in the things of the evil one, but in the things of God. In these beautiful words from St. Matthew's Gospel, Jesus tells us that we should do three things if we are going to live the Christian life. We should pray, we should fast, and we should do good to other people. Those things are not just things that we should do for Lent, but they are things that we should do our entire lives as disciples of Jesus. To pray is to communicate with God. I don't need to explain to you how to do that. You do that every day, both in school and hopefully as well at home. When we fast, we are careful in not overdoing things, not eating too much, not drinking too many sweet drinks, not watching too much TV or playing too many video games, not doing too many things that we enjoy. To do those things, yes, but to do them in moderation. And the third thing is to do good to others, to be kind to people, to speak kindly to them, to think well of them, to act toward others as Jesus would. My friends, if we try each day to do these things as well as we can, to pray, to fast, and to be good to others, to give alms, then we are trying our best to live the Christian life, and to live it well. We find ourselves right now living in very difficult times. This time of COVID has been very difficult for many people. But at the same time, I think this time has given us an opportunity as people of faith who believe in and follow Jesus to look at our blessings, to look at all the wonderful things God does for us each day. As we officially begin on this Ash Wednesday our Lenten journey, let us ask God to help us to be mindful of those blessings and to each day be aware of our responsibility to be good followers, good disciples of Jesus, to pray, to fast, and to be good to others. Why should we do this? Because that is what Jesus would do. And that is what Jesus calls us to do as his faithful followers. I would invite you now to kneel as we spend time in silent adoration to Jesus. And you're going to remain kneeling until the end of our liturgy when I invite you to stand. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please remain kneeling. The divine praises together. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name, blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be his most sacred heart, blessed be his most precious blood, blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar, blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, virgin and mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints. May the heart of Jesus in the most blessed sacrament be praised, adored, and loved with grateful affection at every moment in all the tabernacles of the world, even until the end of time. Amen. Please remain kneeling. We stand.